Hey, everyone, and welcome to the Collider review of the new film Dunkirk, directed and written by some guy you may have heard of named Christopher Nolan, a cast and crew of notable names, and it's all about the battle that took place in 1940 before the United States' involvement in World War II, and I'm joined here by Wendy Lee Zaney. Wendy, this is a story that I don't think most American audiences may be that familiar with, or at least until they started seeing these trailers come out for Dunkirk, and it looked like such an intense, harrowing experience because we know the name brand value that Christopher Nolan brings to the table. So if it's a project he's interested in and it's a story he wants to tell, one would assume we should probably get in the theater and check this spectacle out with our own ears and eyes. What was your initial thoughts on Dunkirk?
Well, initially when the first trailer hit, I saw it and I know because Nolan's behind it, it was going to be beautifully shot. However, war movies has never been my thing. I don't like hop skip to the theater because I want to see devastating things happen at a war movie. So I was actually kind of on the fence about this movie until another colleague had already seen it and said, if you're going to go see this movie, you need to experience it in IMAX and you need to do it very soon. And I said, well, okay.
And that's where you and me were last night, sitting in the IMAX theater. And I'll tell you for myself, I was blown away by this movie. I loved watching Dunkirk. It's a very different kind of movie from most pictures you're going to see in general, but even specifically to war movies. It felt very different for me. And I appreciated what this film was bringing to the table, where it's a lot of nameless people. It's a lot of people you don't necessarily distinguish between them. And I think that's the whole point of the movie, is that there's a lot of namelessness that is involved in war. So it shows the brutality of war, but also shows that your standards sometimes have to fall down from getting a victory and a decisive heroic win to just surviving and making that be the victory of the day. That was certainly the case with Dunkirk. I was blown away by this movie. How about you?
Oh, absolutely. Every single shot they gave us, especially seeing it up on the IMAX screen, was beautiful. While it was devastating seeing what I was seeing with war going on, I never once was like, oh, this is not as good as, you know, enter war movie here. My favorite parts, honestly, was any of the air stuff.
Yeah, I mean, there's three different, you know, styles that you're going to get as far as combat, because you have things going on the land, on the beaches. You have some ships that are coming to help rescue these guys who are stranded against, they're pinned down against the enemy on this beach. Then you also have some aerial stuff going on. Tom Hardy, probably the biggest star in this movie, is one of the fighter pilots. And obviously, this is a non-spoiler review, so we don't want to give anything away, but I thought that all of the different facets of the battle were equally intriguing to me. Not the music by Hans Zimmer so hit home, and it built and it would crest. It was almost like it was waves and something builds up and it hits you and it emotionally floods you, and then you start from scratch again. You start building back up again, and then we rinse and we repeat. So seeing the heroism certainly affected me as a military brat, but it also just gave me a lot of inspiration as far as a film enthusiast. But also, this is an experience that I can't necessarily recommend everybody. If you want to see Dunkirk, you should definitely see it the way Wendy and I did, in an IMAX setting or in a really nice theater. But this is not one of those movies where you're going to just go bumbling in, like you said, with your friends, and you're giggling and you're laughing and you're checking your phone. This ain't that kind of ride, so don't go in for it if that's what you think. This is something that is such an intense, singular experience. It's not that long of a movie, but man, it feels like something that is going to last a lifetime.
It also actually felt long, and it was weird. After I checked my watch when we left, it was just under 2 hours, but the movie felt so much longer. And I also wanted to ask you, this movie, to me, it wasn't dialogue heavy. I feel like Nolan really relied on more of the cinematography and the shots as opposed to using dialogue. And it's different, but I actually quite enjoyed that a little bit more because I liked seeing, and he really put us on that beach with those soldiers.
That's right. And it's survival is here, and rank and file don't really matter anymore. And you even see it, whether it's a soldier trying to get off the beach or a civilian trying to help rescue a bunch of soldiers, that you have names in this movie. We mentioned Tom Hardy, Fionn Whitehead, Kenneth Branagh, Mark Rylance, Harry Styles, my boy, Brian Bernal, they're all in this movie, and you recognize some of them, but you really, none of them stand out as far as, oh, I know that actor, that's a famous person. They all felt like they were part of the troops that we have to get off that beach. So the sound design, the way that the movie was shot, the cinematography, everything about this movie was such a win for me. I think I'm going a little short of giving it a perfect score, but there's the fact that there is no characterizations in this movie, you don't really get a whole lot of backstory, I think might be off-putting to some. Was that the case with you?
That certainly was the case for me. While I really wanted to connect with these soldiers, seeing what they were having to go through from beginning to end, we never got a backstory or anything else. I didn't really feel like I learned about any of the character, with the exception of maybe I can't even remember his name.
Mark Rylance, the guy who stole an Oscar from Sylvester Stallone. He didn't steal it, he earned it.
Oh,
I wouldn't rock it.
A little burn there. Yeah. But I think he and Tom Hardy were maybe the two that I felt like I was able to relate to the most. But everyone else, I really just feel like I couldn't connect. Therefore, I wasn't able to go all the way, submerge myself into this movie as much as I would have liked.
That's right. I mean, Cillian Murphy also plays a soldier, and you get a very different perspective of war from him than you do from, say, Kenneth Branagh. But I thought that they all came together in a film that, again, is not for everybody. But if you think Dunkirk might be for you, if you're a fan of war movies, you want to get this emotional journey, and it's a feast for the eyes and the ears, I recommend Dunkirk, and I can't do it highly enough. I'm going to go very high with my score. Out of 10 is what we do here on Collider.
10,
is that
out
right?
Of 10.
Because our Shmoska, sometimes we do 5, then we went to 10 for like a week, and we went all the way to 100. Now we're back to 5. For this Collider scale, I'm going to go 9 out of 10 for Dunkirk. It's a job well done by Christopher Nolan, and the weird smiling extra was not a factor for me.
Yes. For me, I am on a little bit lower of a scale. I enjoyed it for what it was. The third act was definitely my favorite part, and favorite as in I'm not cheering, as in I felt the most. In fact, when the credits rolled after the third act ended, I realized that I was holding my breath for I don't know how long, and I let out this long, long breath, and I left the movie. This is not just a movie you go and pick up popcorn and hang out with your friends. This is a cinematic experience, and I think those who are into this type of movie should absolutely go see it in IMAX. However, I didn't feel like I was able to connect with any of the characters, therefore caring for them. So while the visuals were stunning and very, very impressive, and I love Nolan and everything he does, I'm going to give this movie a 7 out of 10.
Yeah, we got to see it, and so we're very happy to bring you our review. Most of our colleagues and peers have not had a chance to check it out. There's so much behind the scenes going on right now with us getting down to Comic-Con on time, and then everybody has their individual schedules. They're taking care of their families for stuff. I don't understand it. I wanted to go see Dunkirk. So more of the rest of the Collider folk are going to catch up eventually, but when we're at Comic-Con, this is one of those movies I'd love to have a conversation with anybody who wants to bug me for 5 minutes, because I think it's a really special achievement, and it's one of my favorite movies of the year so far. I can safely say that. So, Wendy Lee Zaney, thank you so much for joining me today. Where can the kids find you at home?
Oh, you can find me at Wendy Lee Zaney on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat.
I am merely Mark Ellis. You guys can find me at Mark Ellis Live. Thanks for tuning in today for our Dunkirk review, and we'll be back soon with another video of some sort.
Hey guys, if you like this video, click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. It'll help you stay up to date with everything we've got going on here at Collider.